SETI stands for the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. And so the Institute looks for aliens in our galaxy and in the universe. Now, we like searching for intelligent aliens. Those are ones that can build telescopes and rockets just like ours. And the trick there is to search for these radio waves that have been traveling through space, maybe for hundreds or thousands of years. And surely by now, advanced civilizations would have come across us and would have arrived on our doorstep and announced themselves. But there's no evidence for that at all. So why is that? I think one of the big things that we don't understand as humans is how ridiculously big the universe is. The concept of distance in space is something that we really can't wrap our heads around. The size of the solar system is incredible. The size of our galaxy is incredible. If our solar system is the size of a quarter, then the Milky Way is the size of North America. Things are so, so far away. And it's quite possible that the signal will come from a star maybe 2,000 light years away. Now, at the speed of light, which is how radio waves travel and visible light travels, that's 2,000 years it's been traveling through space to get to us. So, which means that the message you're getting is already 2,000 years old. We don't know what's happened to that civilization in that meantime. And if we wanted to reply, it's another 2,000 years going out to that world. Now, the aliens may be like trees, you know, that live for thousands of years. 2,000 years, maybe not much at all to these grand old aliens. But to us, there's really never probably going to be such thing as a conversation. The other answer is that we are very, very primitive as a society. We've only been communicating or had the ability to communicate across the stars for maybe a century, and that's nothing. I mean, that's really, really baby steps. I think it's far too early for us to understand what it's like to communicate with advanced civilizations. We're just children. It wouldn't surprise me that in another century, two centuries, we'll suddenly realize that these signals are all around us. And we just did not know how to look for them. And that's one of the tricky things that we have to think about, that we just don't know what we're looking for. Because lots of things produce radio waves. Black holes produce radio waves. Lightning storms produce radio waves. So you've got to sift out all of those different things, as well as human-made signals, like things coming down from satellites and airplanes, and get rid of all of those. And maybe what you've got left is a signal that came potentially from another civilization, an alien society, hundreds or thousands of light years away. I think humans for too long have separated themselves from the planet and the universe that we are naturally a part of. Yeah, I've just been talking about how big the universe is, and it makes us feel small and insignificant, but we're not. We're an integral part of this system. We were born out of, not just our parents and our grandparents, but going all the way back to the earliest formation of life that came from this world. We're made of the stuff that our planet is made of, and we're made of the stuff that our sun is made of. So it's really finding out more about us and our place in the universe as much as finding life elsewhere. And so one day, when we do find life elsewhere in the universe, it's a discovery for all of us.